What is physics? One might say physics is a study of how we use forces and energy to do work. How we use pulleys and gravity. How we use heat. How we use levers. How electricity and magnetism work for us. Physics is a practical study. A study that has many applications besides those we see here. Physics helps us answer questions such as these. How much force is required to start this rocket on its upward flight? How much energy is used in stopping this train? What depth of water will float this ship? How do cranks and gears help us lift heavy loads? Questions such as these belong to the division of physics called mechanics. The study of the action of forces on things, either at rest or in motion. Heat is another division of physics. Heat is related to the motion of molecules within a substance. A third division of physics is light. Light is radiant energy, which produces a sensation of sight. Another division of physics, sound, deals with the vibration of some form of matter. Sounds produce the sensation of hearing. And finally in physics, we study electricity. These are the divisions of physics. Mechanics, heat, light, sound, electricity, and magnetism. Those are the main parts of the study of physics. Now, this motion picture is intended to show you a few things about physics, to help you understand this study of forces and motion and energy in the world around you. And speaking of the world around you, you might notice a movie projector, such as the one which enables you to see this film. It's an application of each of the divisions of physics and an example of how they work together. There is mechanical motion, with several different forces acting on the film, moving it, stopping it for an instant, moving it on. And the movement of the ventilating air is evidence of heat given off by the lamp in the projector. Light coming from this lamp is projected through these lenses to produce an image. Another little lamp sends light through the soundtrack of the film, and sound is produced and amplified for us to hear. And the projector, the sound, the lights, the electric motor is up by electricity. So you see, right here in the room, many applications of all the divisions of physics. But now, let's explore these divisions of physics further. What do we learn in mechanics? We learn about the laws of motion, how force is required to start an object moving. And once it is moving, force again is required to stop it or to change its direction. We learn about action and reaction, how the forces work that propel jet planes forward. We learn something of the nature of gravity, how it affects objects. In the mechanics of liquids, we learn how we can use water pressure and how we can control the flow of water through pipes. We learn how liquids can do useful work. And we learn about buoyancy, why a penny sinks in water, but floats in mercury. These are some of the things we learn in mechanics. In another division of physics, heat, we learn something of the nature of heat and its transmission. For example, how heat is distributed through the air to warm our homes. We learn that objects expand when heated, so that structures like this bridge need specially designed joints to allow for expansion and contraction. Yes, in physics we learn about heat, and we learn about light. We learn the relation between heat and light, and other forms of radiant energy. These include radio waves, with very large wavelengths, the shorter heat or infrared rays, still shorter, visible light of many colors, and ultraviolet waves, the tanning rays of the sun. And we learn how X-rays and still shorter rays of energy compare with all of these. As we become familiar with light, we see how mirrors may be used to show you a clear image of yourself. We come to understand how optical mirrors and lenses are used in telescopes and cameras and microscopes and other devices which, through lenses, help us to see and understand the world about us. These are some of the things we learn about light. As we come to sound, we find quite a different form of energy. Let's try a little experiment. With plenty of air inside the jar, we can hear the bell clearly. But bump the air out of the jar. No, unlike light and other forms of radiant energy, sound waves will not travel through a vacuum. Air, or a solid, or liquid, is needed to carry sound waves. We think of these sound waves as vibrations of some medium. We can imagine that they look something like this. In sound, we learn how a vibrating column of air, a vibrating string, a vibrating membrane in a loudspeaker all produce sounds which we can hear. In addition to sound, we study electricity and magnetism. Here we learn about magnets. And with iron filings, we can study the fields of force around magnets. We learn something of the relationship between magnetism and electricity. A loop of wire passed through magnetic lines of force sets up a small current of electricity. We come to understand how an electric motor operates and how a generator converts mechanical energy into electrical energy for a single bulb or for the needs of an entire area. In batteries, chemical energy is used to provide an electrical current which can be used for a variety of purposes. So you can see how the study of electricity will help us understand the many ways it serves us. And these five subjects usually make up the study we call physics, the study of forces and motion and energy. Now, how do we study physics? Well, one good way is with motion pictures, of course. And we study physics in many other ways, too. When the picture is over, there is much to learn. We watch demonstrations and we perform experiments ourselves using physics textbooks and laboratory manuals. But most of all, we learn physics as a practical science by observing many things around us, by keeping our eyes open to discover the principles of mechanics and heat and light and sound and electricity. We can see how closely these five divisions of physics belong together in one study, the study of forces and motion and energy in the world about us.